there will be lights out. Here we go then, MotoGP underway in Portimao. Lightning start for Dranmir, second place. Nightmare start for Johan Zarco, he missed the start completely. Quartararo also away well from the second row, fifth. Zarco regrouped, but he's in second place. Stunning start for Mir.
Not the start that Marc Marquez wanted. I was watching him, he didn't go forwards off the line. It's his teammate Paul Espargaro who's the first of the Repsol Hondas there, just on the outside of one of the KTMs. Marquez picked up a couple of spots back into turn one, but he's behind the KTM of Miguel Oliveira.
Can you believe this? This is the first time Joan Mir has led a MotoGP race since 2020. As the reigning world champion last year, he didn't lead a single lap. Jack Miller getting aggressive up the inside of Alex Marquez, down the hill into turn number five. Miller starting to pick his way through early onto the podium places. We're looking back there now at the pole man, Johan Zarco. Jack Miller was our cameraman for that view. And it was the perfect time as well because Miller yields. Zarco getting aggressive. He's made a couple of moves there going into turn number 14.
Rins now comes past Paul Espargaro into the top eight, but wide at turn one. Espargaro will reclaim that move, but Rins so aggressive early on.
It will be Mir that leads Quartararo over the line to start lap number four. They again exchange. Fastest lap of the Grand Prix. Quartararo's got the inside line. Slipstreaming on the Yamaha. What about the top speed of the Yamaha? This is a rare mistake. Portimao has not been kind, has it, over the last 12 months for Jorge Martin. This has not been what we expected at all from Marc Marquez in the game. Paul Espargaro leans on his teammate as they go through the first corner. They're swapping the same paint, those two. The Repsol Honda boys having a right old ding-dong here in Portimao. Here comes a dive bomb up the inside of Paul Espargaro into turn number 13. He's made it work this time around. And here comes Bastianini as well, trying to find a way through on Paul Espargaro into turn number 14. Elbows and knees dragging through that penultimate corner. Bastianini can't find a way through just yet. Marquez over the line is 3.2 seconds behind Alex Rins. Fabio Quartararo has gone. He's started to check out. Again, a 1:39.683 from him means he's now 1.8 seconds clear of Joan Mir as Aleix Espargaro fires the Aprilia up the inside of Alex Marquez into turn number five. Alex Marquez says, well, you can have it back on the exit, mate.
Aleix Espargaro looks to get up the inside into turn eight. This is all going to open the door for Alex Rins, who's going to go through this pack like a knife through butter. He's passed Alex Marquez already. Next in his task will be Aleix Espargaro, and that will put him up into the top six.
This is like the last lap of a world championship battle raging between this quartet. Stunning stuff.
Here comes Rins.
Alex Rins up the inside of Aleix Espargaro into turn number 13. Has he got that move done? I'm not sure he has. No, Aleix Espargaro will cut it back and have the inside line now for 14. What a fight this is for fifth place. Turn eight, that went early.
Yeah, he never even arrived at turn eight, did he? He was already off the bike by the time he arrived. Fastest lap of the Grand Prix at 1:39.435. 0.4 faster than Mir and Zarco behind him. Mir and Zarco up their pace. Quartararo said, I've got a response for you. Have a load of this.
This has been an absolute exhibition so far by Fabio Quartararo.
He's into turn 13. He's just behind Brad Binder. He makes contact, I think, with the rear wheel of Binder. It looked like that was what forced him off into the tarmac runoff.
This is where the Suzuki should be stronger in theory, using its agility and its superior corner speed here. And now then, will Zarco be close enough with a bit of slipstream? Was there a bit of wheelie there from Mir as well, coming out the final corner? I think there was. And Johan Zarco says, thank you very much. Didn't really have to work that hard for that move. He just powers the Ducati on by. In hot, though. Did he just get a bit of extra speed with the slipstream, or was there a gust of wind that's pushed him in hot?
As Zarco once again breezes past the Suzuki on the start-finish straight. Can he get it stopped this time into turn one? Mir doing his level best on the brakes. Zarco, though, this time would appear to have got it stopped. Can he now pull away from the 2020 world champion?
It's a game of chess on the brakes now into the first corner.
Oh! Oh! No!
Miller! Miller on the front end, loose to the front, trying to find a way through at the inside of Joan Mir.
Jack Miller up the inside. You could see how desperately late he was breaking. The front just tucks, and Joan Mir absolutely nowhere to go.
Miller used the power of the Ducati to get alongside Mir in the braking zone for turn one. But as he turned in, squeezing that front brake lever, the front end just gave up.
Alex looks like he's got much better drive out of the last corner.
Yeah, again, turn 15, it just looks like that's been a part of this circuit where Marc Marquez has found it really, really difficult to get that rear tyre hooked up, and he's certainly getting it hard to stop that Repsol Honda into the first corner somehow. He makes the apex.
Here he goes, and Mark through on Alex too.
Yeah, Pekka Bagnaia was going for it. He's just maybe going to run Polisvargo a little bit wide. Polisvargo will cut back and have the inside line then into turn number 14. But here comes Fabio Quartararo. It has been picture perfect in Portugal for the reigning world champion. He's the winner of the Tissot Grand Prix of Portugal in utterly dominant fashion. Alex Marquez, will he snatch six? No, he doesn't. That's a battle won by older brother Mark Marquez. Fabio Quartararo's first win since the British Grand Prix at Silverstone. Prove you cannot keep a good man down. What a job by the two Frenchmen all weekend. An excellent fifth place. That's one of the best dry race results that Miguel Oliveira's had in quite some time.
But the reigning world champion rode like a champion today. FIM President Jorge Viegas congratulates our top three, Fabio Quartararo, on another planet this afternoon, as he takes his first victory of the season, and with it the lead of the World Championship.